Hi, and welcome to St. Cecilia's. It's such a pleasure to welcome you here virtually and in person for an organ concert that I've been really excited for this whole season. We have here in Boston an incredible composer and organist, and to have someone who's equally good at both of those is rare these days. And Richard Clark is one of the best in each one of those individually. He's going to play a program of his own works, as well as Jehan, Alain, and Buxtehude, and other great great organ composers, great organist composers. And he knows this organ here at St. Cecilia's, well, better than anyone. Certainly better than I do. He worked here, what, 28 years? Yeah, so he knows what he's doing. He's the reason that this organ is sounding as well as it is today, and the reason that we have the antiphonal division downstairs, and the reason that many other good things have happened here. So here we go. Do you want to say something, Richard?
Thank you, Thomas. And you're very lucky to have Thomas here playing here. If for those of you who are watching virtually, you want to get into this building and listen to this instrument and listen to Thomas play. Happy Lent, everyone. I've got my purple tie on today to celebrate Lent. Lent actually can be joyful. We're looking forward to the resurrection and baptism. The first piece is variations on the Gregorian chant, Misereris Omnium. What's really extraordinary about this is it is the very first prayer. It is the first thing sung as according to the church in Lent, Ash Wednesday. It is the introit chant. And this isn't a recent thing. Misereris Omnium, it means your mercy extends to all things. Your mercy is infinite. Your mercy is boundless. God's mercy has no boundaries. There are people I know who need boundaries, but God has no boundaries. His mercy has none. This is mind-blowing, absolutely mind-blowing. This is not a new Vatican II thing. We've been singing this in the church for at least 1,300 years, maybe 1,400 years, and this is from the Book of Wisdom. If you get nothing from this concert, look at the Book of Wisdom, chapter 11, start with verse 24. This is thousands of years old of wisdom, God's infinite mercy. So in Lent, we begin in one place, and we end in another. And much of the music today that I'll be playing, you begin in one place, and you transform, and you end someplace else.
Thank you.
We're going to move from Boston to Paris. We're going to visit Sainte-Clotilde, Saint-Germain-en-Laye, and l'Église de la Trinité. Sainte-Clotilde is where Jehan Langlais, who's the titular organist, again, a piece that explores all of these three pieces by these French composers, explore color. They explore the darkness and the light. Without the darkness, without Good Friday, there is no Easter Sunday. Without the darkness, you cannot see the stars. Jehan Langlais' work, Ave Maria, and the very mystical Ave Maria Stella, Mary Star of the Sea. It's a beautiful work, which begins in one way and ends in another. Jean Elan, another amazing composer, cut short in life, friends with Messiaen, born similar time period, had he lived, died in World War II in 1940. His sister became the most celebrated organist in the entire world during the 20th century, Marie-Claire Land. I met her in 1999, and because she was a girl, they didn't bother to give her organ lessons. The whole family were musicians. And she was a girl, so they didn't come to mind. And I asked her, I said, how did you feel not being taught anything? And she really didn't have an answer, so I'm still mystified. She didn't really give me a good answer. Apparently, it didn't stop her. She was the most celebrated organist. And of course, through her, she was able to shed the light on her extraordinary brother, Jean Elan. And of course, finally, there's Olivier Messiaen. Jesus accepts la souffrance. Jesus accepts suffering. He accepts the cross. You will hear in this the scourging of the pillar. You will hear the four-note cross, the theme that represents the cross. You will hear the nails. I will ask you to listen for the resurrection.
Thank you.
This has been a lot of fun to come back here and experience this instrument. This is an old friend. I enjoyed also climbing inside the chambers and tweaking a couple of notes that needed adjustment, things that I think are fun. So we're going to little another change of pace to a real fun piece by Buxtehude, certainly a great influence on Johann Sebastian Bach. But I just want to emphasize again, if you are watching this on a live stream, there's nothing like being here in person. Please come here to one of these concerts, come to Mass, come hear Thomas Mellon play, come hear one of these other great concerts that are happening here. This room is glorious. This is one of the most extraordinary unions of instrument and architecture, not just in Boston, really anywhere. Anywhere. That's just not, and those are not my words, that's been pointed out. Many other organists have said that, but this is a phenomenal union of instrument and architecture. Please come here. Please come to St. Cecilia Parish, the patron saint of music.